Mr. or Mrs. Bass, I have a question. What floats your boat? Wow, nice. This is one of those days I'll probably forget it right away. Oh my gosh. Well, good morning, folks. Here we are somewhere in Pettis County, Missouri. This is a big bass lake, and I'm waiting for the clouds and wind, and that should get things going. Mr. Weatherman is calling for severe thunderstorms in the central Missouri area today, so let's take advantage of the time that we have. I can't remember the last time I fished this lake, but I also like it because it gives me a chance to do Christmas shopping for Sparky so he can fill up his tackle box. That way he'll maybe get cheered up. There you go, buddy. Those are pretty colors. You'll like that. Temperature right now is 80 degrees. Okay, water is stained. A couple of feet of visibility. Pool is overfull. There's a little bit of water going over the bridge. Had to take a detour around Robin Hood's barn to get here. But we're here, and there are things swimming down there, so we'll see how it goes. So here it is, the boat float. Yeah, you got tired, or just lay down and be cutesy wootsy. That's a very pretty boy. Hey, Rudy. Are you being cutesy wootsy just like a boat float? Why not? And I have it rigged up on a 2-aught extra wide gap gammy hook and a little bullet weight. Of course, you could put them on a Ned head, whatever you want. They're 2.75 inches long. I'm using funky color, which is just a great color because it's just so funky. And they come fortified with MegaStrike. So I don't even bother putting any additional MegaStrike on them. I really have not seen a more sparkly eye candy looking lure than this one. Well, I didn't expect this, but it happened. Okay, Mr. Crappie, we know what floats your boat. Come on, let's get to work. I'm fishing the boat float just like any other Texas rig finesse lures. Finally get to see something. Getting its boat floated. Yeah, nice. Come on. Thank you very much. Mr. or Mrs. Bass, I have a question. What floats your boat? Wow, nice. Healthy bass in this lake. Very nice plump fish. Comes in at a little over 15 and a half. And just out of curiosity, check this guy out. Yep, kind of figured it'd be in that range. And that's not a very big fish coming in at that weight. He sure did make your boat float, buddy. Boat float tuggers are not always bass. This fish here feels like a monster. It is not going anywhere. I'm afraid it might be a Mr. Whiskers. The line's kind of going little figure eights like they do when they get their head down. yet. Stay over this side. This is exciting, but if this is a bass, I'm gonna go, yeah! In the interest of time, this battle is definitely gonna have to be shortened and edited. Okay, leader's up out of the water, I think. Yep, leader's out of the water, so he's getting tired. Did I mention that this was the maiden voyage of the boat float? Oh my goodness, I think I just caught a trolling motor. All right, Bill, you go out to Lake Erie and catch these things all the time, but it's a little unusual for me to hit a monster like this. But we did it! We did it! Yeah! I'm not entirely sure I won't even mess with this big guy, but at this point in time, I have no choice. What if I put the clipper grippers on him right now so he can't get away? First part of this circus will be to get him onto the measuring board without him breaking my arm or blowing up the float tube. Bill or Mike, what do you think? Is that a behemoth? Coming in at just shy of 27 and a half. It's one of those days I'll probably forget it right away. Oh my gosh. Alright, let's see how much you weigh. Oh my goodness. Well, Mr. Kitty, as much as I'd like to hang around and pet you, teach you tricks like Rudy knows, I think it's time for you to go back to your den or wherever you came from. We'll see you later, maybe. Pretty steep bank. I'm sitting at 11 feet and I'm out from the bank around 15 or so. Down in a stick or something. In this debut of the boat float, I'd say that it's pretty good. It's not available on the Bear Paws website yet, but maybe by the time you see this, they will be available on the website. What on earth? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Here we go again. Pinch me, I'm dreaming. Sound drill. Pinch his lip so he doesn't bite me. See, their mouth is real fleshy. So a wide gap hook like this tends to catch them almost every time. As much as I don't want to do this, let's get on with it. Alright. There we go. That's a nice size catfish on the board at 24, a little over 24. Okay, let's go. Pounds, 5 ounces. That's enough catfish drama for one day. Thank you very much. I really enjoy catching you guys, but you're just such a mess to fuss with. See you later. Please be a bass. I'm getting sick and tired of catfish. Yes, thank you. All right. Finally get to see a bass. It's been a while. There you go, buddy. I'm just flipping this boat float over near the bank, foot or so out, letting it sink, and then just sort of bringing it out. And when they bump your line, Set the hook. I think this is a bass too, hopefully. Come on, come on, come on. Please. Yep. Putting on a good show today, guys. You're probably not even gonna make it into the video anyway. See ya. Well, folks, we're gonna have to call the maiden voyage of the boat float to a halt. From our house to your house, thanks for coming along today. And until we see you again, God bless.